Hari Om. My name is Madhuveera Behel and I'm from Mumbai. I'm here today to share my impressions about the recently held event on the 26th of May, Naho Tujhya Preme. Naho Tujhya Preme started quite some time before the 26th of May. The care with which it was announced, the concern with which it was launched is something which touched my heart even before the event started. We were informed about what the program would be. There were promos about, you know, the love and care that we feel for Bapu. Little things like the bus routes, little things like carrying your caps, taking water bottles, it all set the tone. It set the tone, the love and concern that was going to be experienced at the event. Well, finally comes the 26th of May and I have 102 fever, but we decided that we are going to go ahead. And it was only with Bapu's grace that one was there. From the highway, there was somebody to guide us right through till our seat. You know, it was just so smooth. It just flowed. You felt like a VIP who was being escorted. And this was true for each one who came in. We sat there. When I entered the stadium, I was awed. The number of people, it was packed. But what awed me was not the number of people, but the peace, the quiet, the calm, the stillness. There was no stampede, there was no noise. Everybody was there. Everybody was there waiting. Everybody was there in love. It just set the tone. There was so much of togetherness. The show was as professional as it can be, right from the stage to the, you know, to the banners right through the stadium. The rows and rows of chairs neatly there. One could sense the immaculate planning, the meticulous planning that had been happening. The unsung heroes who would have done so much of work across levels, across skill sets, right from our top management to the last level. And deeply ambadnya to each one who made this possible for us. And I can very, very confidently say ambadnya on behalf of all the people who were there. The live streaming. I've spoken to so many people after the event and it was flawless. So not only were people, 40,000-50,000 people in the stadium, but people across the globe connected. The musicians, the orchestra, it was really, really professional. And what amazed me was that everything else in our organization had gone on. It wasn't that everything had come to a standstill because of 26 May. Everything went on. That was a learning for me. Everything goes on in life simultaneously with peace, with grace, with calm. So that was the mega event part. The part which was very, very obvious, the part which was apparent. But Naho Tujhya Preme for me meant something else. It was a very intense personal journey, very, very intense personal experience. The words that come up for me was that it was caressing. I felt very loved, very, very loved. It was a very soul-touching, very in-depth experience. As the singer sang there, what was beautiful was that nobody was performing. Nobody was performing. The singers just sang. They sang from their heart. They sang with a lot of love. They sang with a lot of devotion. You know, suddenly during the event, you found somebody folding their hands, somebody saying a silent prayer. It was a very, very divine atmosphere. There were about 40,000-50,000 people there, all together. And it felt everybody's voice had rolled into that one voice of the singer on the mic. We were all singing. We were all expressing our love. And it was that one singer who was a representative who carried all the voices at the divine feet of our Bapu, I and Dada. That, of course, was another experience just watching them. For hours getting to see them, be with them, experience their grace. After a certain time, who was singing, who was giving, who was receiving was all mine. We were offering to Bapu, Bapu was giving us, we were receiving from him, we were giving him. It was just very, very divine. As each number went on, I've been in the Bapu family since the year 2000, so these numbers are very, very dear. Very dear. Each one, there's been, you know, it was an occasion where I could sing. I would have never imagined that I could get to sing in front of my Bapu in my broken voice and my absolutely surreal tone. But I could actually sing to him all that I've been wanting to tell him since so many years. So that was beautiful. And then there was this floodgate of memories which just opened. And as the numbers went by, you know, there was something that was happening outside on the screen. But within the mind, within the heart, within the soul, one remembered. One remembered all the grace. One remembered all the support, all the love, all the motivation, all the guidance. All that we have been receiving, we've just been receiving so much since the last so many years. And this was an occasion where one just remembered, one could thank, one could be grateful. One just could surrender. It was an occasion to remember everything. One hadn't forgotten, but it really, really anchored me. It anchored me from deep within. It reconnected me. It reconnected me, and it made me feel once again that life actually is very, very simple. You know, what really matters is that he's mine and I'm his. And he is there. So it's all very simple. Why the complications? That was a huge, huge reassurance, learning once again. And last but not the least, I would like to thank Sameer Dada, who's been rock solid. He's been rock solid always. He's been rock solid behind this event and everything that happens to us. So heartfelt ambadmeh from me.